الرحمن الرحيم ربي اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي امري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي. Ladies and gentlemen, dear students, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. First of all, I'm very grateful to the most exalted, to the most kind Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for giving us the sense to differentiate between right and wrong, for creating us as human beings, for creating us as the Ummati of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and for showing us the path of guidance through the light of Quran. Then I'd like to thank my parents, my family, my teachers, my well-wishers for supporting me and helping me. I'd like to say thanks to the Mathematics Society of the Ghulam Asad Khan Institute of Technology for inviting me to have a talk on the future of the nation. Ladies and gentlemen, as this is all about mathematics, I can't help talking about it, but I will not go so deep in it. Like, I won't talk about the great history of mathematics as it comes from the Stone Age to the Egyptians to the Greeks. I don't have time to go so deep in the lives of the great mathematicians, Leonard Euclid, Pythagoras, Al-Khwarizmi. I don't have much time to speak about the big number. Google Plex, Googleplex again. Grams number, 3-3, royal numbers, very interesting, I suggest you search it. But I want to see something different. What is mathematics? Mathematics is the language of understanding nature. It is in the building blocks of our life, like the Fibonacci numbers, they are natural in life, like in Ramadan, that's where Fibonacci discovered them. So, it is in the building blocks of our life. From the biggest skyscraper to the smallest atom, in the inner planets, even in sports, maths is everywhere. And maths teaches us two principles. One, that how to solve a problem in different ways, like there are 10 beads on a table and somebody counts them 1, 2, 3, 4 and somebody counts them by making bond numbers like 3 multiplied by 3 equals 9 plus 1 equals to 10. So that's the same answer but different ways. So maths teaches us how to solve a problem in different ways, different solutions to the same problem. Maths also teaches us to arrange things in order, like 2 plus 2 minus 2 multiplied by 2 divided by 2. Due to the Damash rule which math teaches us, we can understand and solve the answer properly. If we didn't put it in order, we couldn't solve it and there would be many problems. There would be many answers and we would be confused. And that's what math teaches us. Like, there are books on a table, you arrange them, there are volumes. Like volume 1 down, then volume 2 on top, volume 3 on top, volume 4 on top, volume 5. Well, if you didn't know maths, it would be like volume 1 on top, then volume 5, then volume 2, and it will be just mixed up. So maths teaches us these two principles that are used in our daily lives. I want to share with you how to put principles, these principles in our daily life, how to stack things in order. First of all, we'll have to set our targets. And we have to set up targets, what I have to do in this life, what special I have to do in this life before I die. And here's my advice to you, that you should set your targets big. You should dream big. Because if you try to shoot the stars and you miss, you'll definitely shoot the sky. So if you try to get to a big target and you miss, you'll be somewhat nearer to the target. Have a clear vision for that target. Now, to get that target, you'll have to face many problems and you'll have to focus on it because there will be many diversions to come to you left and right to do. So when you want to get your target, you'll have to stay focused. You don't have to just get diverted by the diversions will be coming. There will be a lot of diversions coming when you set off on the journey to get your targets. Have anybody heard of Sylvester Stallone, the great actor who died a few months ago? He is known for many movies. Do you know his story? You might know him as a great actor. He was born in a very poor family. He was very poor and he had to sleep on the streets every night. So one day he seen a match between Muhammad Ali, the great boxer, and Chuck McWeber, which inspired him to write the story. story of Rocky, the movie which was published and which was released in 1976. So he gave it to a media, a publishing company, and they said he can be the director and we're gonna give you 100 grand and you be the director, we're gonna make somebody else act. But he didn't budge on that opinion. It was his dream to become an actor. That's why he didn't budge on that opinion. So that's how his dream was to be an actor, so he stayed focused on it. And he didn't get diverted by the diversion which were coming to him. He stayed focused on that part. He stayed focused on that part and now he's in films alive. You can see, he focused on that way, he wanted his dream, he got his dream because he focused on it. And the divergence came, but he was focused, he stayed put on art. Is hard work. Work hard. You see, this is the life, this is the law of this universe. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made this universe to be, when you want to get something, it will be hard. There will be divergence coming to you. And it won't be easy. Generally, it won't be easy. It will have a lot of hard work. We'll have to work hard even though we hit it. You'll have to work hard for it. As I say, when you work hard, you get the fruit of it. So when you work hard, you get the fruit of it, no matter what. Like Muhammad Ali says, I hated every minute of training. But I said, don't quit, suffer now, and live the rest of your life as a champ. And speaking of Muhammad Ali, does anybody know him? You might have known him as a great boxer. But do you know his life story? He was born in a town, and when he was 12 years, his bicycle was stolen. So he told the police inspector he met that he'd find the person and he'd beat the person who had stolen his bicycle. The coach, who was a boxing trainer, took him under his wing and started training him for boxing. And Muhammad Ali, he worked hard. He trained day and night, and he perspired, and he sweated. And that's how in 1960 he won the junior lightweight championships in Rome. So you see, there is a great example of what hard work. You see, we have to work hard for everything we want to get, and then we'll get the fruit of it. It gives us a really good sense of accomplishment when we work hard and then we get the fruit of it. Next thing I want to share with you is, you'll have to be patient. You know, when you have to get something, there'll be many hardships coming to you. There'll be many problems. Problems will try to trouble you. Troubles will come to you. Hurdles will try to hurdle you. Crust and crust will try to drown you. Ups and downs will try to topple you. Circumstances will try to grieve you. But you'll have to stay strong. You'll have to stay brave. That's what patience is. Patience is not that you get beaten and you get grinded and you get crushed and you just weep and do nothing. Patience is you get grinded. You get up, you endure all of it, and you stay put on the straight path. You stay put on the path which leads you. You stay put on the journey. You don't leave the journey. And you don't give up. The one example which comes to my mind when I think of patience, I've read many books about him. He is a really influential person. He's said, "Inwa inna kala ala khuluki nasi." He's rahmatul lil alamin. When he used to teach his message, the tribes over there, they said that they'll give him wealth, they'll give him money, they'll give him the whole kingdom. But he said, "I will not stop my teaching." They even threatened him for life on the other hand. But he said, "You know what he said? Even if you put the sun in my right hand and the moon in my left hand, I will not stop my teaching." Who was he? Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And that made him an influential person of the time. So these are some steps I achieve and take the steps and achieve your dream and get your dream. No matter how tough it is, you'll have to endure it. You'll have to work hard for it. You'll have to stay focused and you'll have to stay put on it. You don't ever get diverted by the divert. I know, there'll be many circumstances, dreams, trust and drops, ups and downs, coming to you left and right. But you'll have to stay strong and you'll not have to lose your heart and you'll never have to give up. This is what I want you to remember, and this is what I want you to chase your dream. You'll have to chase your dream, and you'll have to endure all the circumstances that come to you. And at last, I want to say to you that you trust in your Lord, who is Ar-Rahman, Surah Ar-Rahman, who is Ar-Rahim, Surah Al-Fatiha, who is Wallazi Khalaka Sabaha Samawati Intibaqa, who is Al-Ahkam Al-Hakimin, Surah Al-Teen. And one last thing I want to say. Be good to yourself on an individual level. Be nice to your surroundings. Be nice to your family. Be kind to your neighbors. Be loyal to your country. Don't let your country down. Don't do anything that lets your country down. And at last, as being a resident of planet Earth, as being a resident of humanity, as being a part of humanity, do something good to humanity. Be peaceful to humanity. Be a proud resident of humanity. Do something that makes you feel proud as a resident of humanity. Do something great to humanity. Assalamu alaikum.